Gentlemen, good morning again from the flight deck. Your captain speaking with an update.
Hi guys, we just arrived in LA. We actually are already at our Airbnb and we picked up our car. We had a lot of struggles, so I didn't film anything. I'll just start at the beginning. So we flew to LA. When we arrived at the airport, we actually wanted to hurry up and get our car and go to the Airbnb because we asked for an earlier check-in. But then at the security or at the border control, like when you get off the plane and you have the final check before you can actually get your suitcase back, the guy asked me, like, they always ask questions like how long are you staying and I don't know, all of these security questions. And they asked me, do you have any food or tobacco or alcohol? And I said, yeah, I just have an apple and a banana. And I kind of said it as a joke because I had those, but I just thought those were innocent. And he was really serious and he asked, where are they? And I said, they are in my bag. And then I had to take them out and give them, and then he had to call agriculture or something and they had to come. And then we had to wait for them to come. So we were standing there already in line for maybe like half an hour. And then we finally got to the security, and then we had to wait an extra half an hour or something to wait for the people from agriculture to come, but they didn't come. And then we had to go there by ourselves. And the guy told us they were busy, so we had to go there by ourselves. And then we came there and nobody was doing anything. But they were really friendly and they just, like, they threw our banana and apples away and they told us that it's not allowed. And apparently you cannot take food in the US, so learn from our mistake and don't bring anything. In the airplane it's fine, but just don't take it when you get out of the airplane and try to get it in when you're going to collect your suitcase. So then we finally got our luggage and stuff, and then we went to pick up our car. And we really wanted a Jeep Wrangler, but we booked a mid-size SUV because we couldn't find, like, booking directly a Jeep Wrangler. So we thought a mid-size SUV would be like the category it would be in. And then we asked if they had any, but they actually had one, but we would have to pay more. So we had to go to the counter and we asked how much we would pay more. And at first she said $400, and that was almost double than what we paid. We paid like €600, so not double, but she said €400, and now we had to pay that was too much. And then she checked if she could change the price, and she actually could change the price to $240. And yeah, we already saw the Jeep Wrangler, and it was a hybrid electric. It only had, oh no, we didn't know yet, so, and it looked really good, so we couldn't pass it on for €240. It's actually a lot of money, but we had a really good deal initially on our car rental. So now that we had to pay extra, it's still a good deal. So we are really happy we got the Jeep Wrangler. I'll show you in a minute, but it's a really nice car. It only has like 900 miles, so it's practically new. And it's a really, really nice one. And you can open up the top. It's a soft top. And it's really my dream car. I really, really wanted this car. And last year we really wanted a Ford Mustang, and we got the Ford Mustang, and now this year we really wanted the Jeep Wrangler, and we actually got it, like, our dream car again. And I'm just obsessed, and I started driving it and I really had to get used to it because it's an automatic and I'm used to driving manual. So I had to get used to the automatic, and then when we, like, drove off of the parking lot from our car rental, I actually stepped on the brake really hard because I had to get used to the brake being really sensitive. So I stepped on the brake because we had to go on the road. And then the thing you drive through that goes up, it went on our car because I hit the brake. And then the thing actually fell off. Oh my god. And but they allowed us to drive, and they basically just told us get out of here, I think. I don't know. So we got out, and then I really had to get used to the brake. Like, on the road I actually hit the brake again accidentally, and we were lucky we didn't cause an accident, or I was lucky. But we arrived safely, and then we actually drove to the wrong, like there are two, like we drove to our Airbnb, and we drove through the wrong one. Well, it's the same street, and the number was the same, but it didn't look like the pictures, and we actually took all this time to park our car, because it was really difficult, and then we found out we were on the wrong street, and we had to drive 4 minutes, and now we are at the right Airbnb. So I'm going to show you our Airbnb, it's really cute, and our car, because it's really insane. Oh, and I didn't tell you what time it is. It's, let me check. It's 5 o'clock, but I'll tell you what we are going to do next. Okay, guys, this is our car. It's really crazy. It's really, really big. I don't know if you can see on camera. But at home, we drive a mini. So that's really, like a really tiny car. And this one's huge. So I really had to get used to it. But it's really nice. And it's so hybrid. So it's electric, but also, you can also fill it up with gas. So it's really, like, cost efficient. So, really, really nice. And then I'll show you the inside. It's really brand new. You have like this display here. And you, I think we actually have Apple CarPlay, but we need to check. And then you just have the back seat. And then let me show you the back. So this is where our suitcases are. And you actually open it like this. And it's really cool. But I'll show you when. But I'll show you once we, oh my god, I left the car keys in. But I'll show you what. Oh my god. Oh my gosh. I accidentally clicked on the wrong button. So you open it like this, which I think is really fun. And then you have our suitcases and everything fits perfectly. I'll quickly show you our Airbnb. So this is where you come in. It's actually a house divided in multiple apartments. So we come in through the back door. And then you get into the bedroom. And you have this little kitchen area. Just with a refrigerator and stuff. And then here you have our bathroom. Not going to use this part. But just have the walk-in. Oh, let me put on the lights. So we have a walk-in shower, or not really a walk-in shower, but just a shower. So we really like this. And I just think this looks really cute. And then, I think that's it. What's here? Oh yeah, this is just like a closet. It's just a closet. I don't know where the light is. And you have two big mirrors, which is always handy. So that's our Airbnb. We just quickly changed into shorts and some hiking shoes, because we are going on a hike. I actually didn't tell you, but we are in LA for 3 nights and we are doing a road trip. So we are starting in LA and then we are going to Yosemite, Sequoia, like a lot of different national parks. And then we are ending our road trip in Las Vegas. And we are in the US for 21 days. And Las Vegas, we are also a couple of nights. But this is our first day in LA, but because we are so late because of the delay, we can't actually do everything we have planned. We have actually planned out every day, so we know exactly what we want to do every day. But because we are kind of late today, we cannot actually do everything we wanted to do. But now we are going on a hike. And then we are going to drive through like this street with a lot of expensive houses. And it's in the mountains, so you have or in the hills. I don't know if you call it hills. But you have this really nice view of LA. And also in the hike, you have a really nice view. It is kind of cloudy, but we'll see. And then tonight, we are actually going to eat at In-N-Out. So I'm really excited. So now we are going back in the car and actually and drive to the Hollywood sign or to the starting point of the hike. I'll actually put the link of our document in the description below so you can see our whole planning and everything we planned out for our holiday. So you can find it in the description. But so you can also find the starting point of the hike and everything. So yeah, let's go.
good morning, it's day 2. And it's now 5:30. We woke up a little bit before 4, maybe 3:30. And we decided to just wake up because we're still a bit jet lagged and we wanted to see the sunrise. So now we actually drove through to Griffith Observatory, but we parked at the Greek Theater and now it's about a 15 minute walk to the observatory because the Greek Theater, the parking is free. We are now at the Griffith Observatory, but we were doubting if we wanted to go at sunrise because it's so cloudy, but it's still really pretty. So I think you can go anytime. It will always be pretty because you see all of the lights. Maybe the only time it's not pretty is if it's really foggy and you cannot even see the city. But when you're at the Griffith, you can actually see Hollywood right behind me. Oh, right there. And then in front of me, you can see the city and you can walk all around the observatory. And here you can actually see the canyon.
Hoe heet het ook weer?
The Runyon Canyon Trail. And here is the little bench you always see on pictures. And we actually also wanted to do this hike, but on another day. But now we're not sure if we actually want to do it. Maybe if we have time, because it's still really pretty. But if we are running out of time, we might skip this trail.
Love feels like drugs. Even good nights get you high. Little bit wild, but it's alright. Even bright lights got a dark side. Even good love feels like drugs. Even good times get you high. Little bit lost, but it's alright. Even bright lights got a dark side. Pleasure is pain and the pain is pleasure. Grass won't grow with no rainy weather. We keep flipping coins for luck and we're just trying to ease the suffering. Broke a heart first in my own, got shattered. Never one tear really ever mattered. World keeps on turning and we all keep learning that even good love feels like drugs. Even good nights get you high.
Dat is echt heel zoet en heel veel smaak. Heb je dat niet? Ja? Mijn proeft heel erg naar die amandel. Misschien zit dat een beetje onderin. Ik proef geen koffie nog niet echt. Wow, die butter pecan. We just stopped at our Airbnb. And we're now going to walk to this shopping center. Because we really need to buy water. And I forgot some things, so we need to buy them at like CVS or maybe Target, I don't know. And then we're just going to go shopping a little bit. Because there's this shopping mall and it's only 50 minute walk. We just came home from Target. I actually changed because it was really... I was getting sick from how hot I was getting. But we just came back from Target. I'll show you what we bought. I actually got a different gel. I never used this before, but I forgot my tretinoin from home. Because it's in the refrigerator and I just forgot. And I figured while we are here, because we are here for 3 weeks, I would just use different. Because it's basically kind of the same as tretinoin. Like it's a retinol. So I'll just use that one. Then I just got some period pads because I didn't bring those. And then we got the this is actually wet. Then we just got some body lotion to use as after sun. Apparently this one's really good. It's a body gel cream, so I figured we could use this as a body lotion. And this one has hyaluronic acid in it. It's the Hydro Boost body gel cream from Neutrogena, and it actually smells really fresh, so I really like this. So I think this will be really nice. And then the last thing I bought was some cotton pads, because I also forgot, or cotton swabs, because I also forgot those. And then lastly, we just got like a big bottle of water so we can fill up our Yeti cups. And then we just need to buy some smaller bottles, like a 24 pack to put in our car. But we were walking, so we decided to just get one of these. And then we'll just fill up our bottles. And that's everything we got. And now we are going to drive to In-N-Out. But I'll tell you in the car what we're going to get. Because yesterday we didn't go to In-N-Out anymore. After we went to do the hike and stuff, or just the hike, we decided to just go to sleep. Because we planned on doing like a few different things and then eat at In-N-Out. But it was already like 9 or something. So, and we were really tired because of the jet lag. So we decided to just go to sleep and then just do the sunrise hike today. But now we are really craving In-N-Out. It's now, I think it's not even 11. And we actually wanted to get In-N-Out this morning, but it was still closed. So now we are going to go right now. We didn't eat anything yet. We just had the Dunkin', but we really want to get some In-N-Out. This is the first time we are going to In-N-Out, and we really wanted to go in LA because In-N-Out is originally from LA, so we really want to go here. And we are now driving to the most, and we are now going to the most famous location, and it's the one where you can see airplanes taking off. You see this location a lot on pictures with like the In-N-Out logo and then the airplanes going off or taking off. Double double, and then Marcus got the animal style, which is of the secret menu. Oh, with chilies. And then I got just a normal double double, and then a toasted bun. And then we got the fries well done, because you can order actually everything how you like it. So you can say everything you like. So we got the fries well done, and then Marcus got the animal style fries, and then we just got one coke to share. Just finished. We really like these burgers. You can custom made everything like how you want it, and they only have like a few things on the menu. They have a really basic menu, like only a few things on the menu, but you can actually ask anything you like. And then the animal style isn't on the menu, and it's like onions, cheese, and a special sauce, and it's kind of like the Big Mac sauce from McDonald's. And I didn't really like the animal style burger. It's really heftig. Like, it's a really extreme taste. I don't know how you say it, but I just had the regular double double burger, and it was really good. I think it's my favorite burger so far, but it can also be because it's the first burger we had this year, like in the US. And we got the fries well done, so they were more crispy, but I thought they were a bit too crispy, and I actually preferred the animal style fries. And with those style, I actually liked the well done. When you get animal style, they actually steam your fries and you get all of those toppings, so they get a little bit softer. So I would recommend the animal style fries and just the regular burger. But Mark really liked the animal style burger and the fries as well, though.
Yeah. So now we're actually going to the Broad Museum, which is a free museum, which is a really cool museum you will see. And we're also going to the Last Bookstore, which is a really old bookstore. And then there's also in like those things are like really close. So we're just going to park at the Broad Museum. And then there's also this matcha tea master matcha cafe where you can get like a lot of things with matcha. But we really just want to get their matcha drink. And I think that's it for now. So now we're going to drive to the Broad Museum parking. We just got back into our Airbnb and we just got the tacos for takeaway. I'll show you. It doesn't look as good as they did because it's been maybe 45 minutes. But we have a burrito to go, to share. I'll show you when we open it. This is a taco with El Pastor. It's pork. This is from Mark. And they actually, I think I filmed it. They put cheese on the plate and then they put your taco on top. So you have your melted cheese on your taco, basically. And then they put all the toppings and your meat. Then this is one we share. It's a Vampiro. It's kind of like a crispier taco. I don't know how to explain it. And then I think we took this one with chicken. Yeah, it's chicken. And then they put like toppings you can choose, guacamole. And then these spicy sauce and another sauce we couldn't really, we didn't really understand what they said, but we just took everything. This is my taco. This is also with chicken. And then I also added onion. Oh, and I took the keto taco. And then you could take this plastic bag and put like the vegetables. You could take them yourself. I don't think I filmed those baskets. And that's everything we had. So it doesn't look as good as it did. But it smells really, really good. And then we have a burrito to share. And we took the burrito with steak. And there's a lot of different meat options. But I don't eat pork. So the things we share, we took with chicken on steak.
And we decided to eat it in the hotel room. Because you couldn't eat at the taco place. It's street tacos, so they just had to stand at the street. And we thought we saw on Google they had like picnic tables, but they didn't have. Maybe it was on a different location. So we decided to just get it for takeout and go back to the hotel. So it's not as hot anymore. But and we also really wanted to eat inside because we're really tired from all the walking. And now we cannot wait to eat.
Oh, and I forgot to tell. To show this. This is they had a couple of different homemade lemonades. Or maybe juices. I don't know. But this was the pineapple flavor. They also had strawberry. And just a regular lemonade flavor. And they had something else. But we didn't really understand what they were saying. So we chose the pineapple one. We just finished eating. I think we only ate half of it. We ordered way too much. It wasn't as good as we thought it would be. The cheese didn't have really had any taste. We didn't really like the meat. Only we did like the chicken. And we did put like the spicy sauce on all of them. And it kind of ruined it for us. Because it was way too spicy. So it was kind of a bummer. We expected a lot. Maybe we just expected a lot. And also it was kind of colder. So maybe it was our own fault that we didn't eat it right away. But it wasn't as good as we thought it would be. But my favorite was the pineapple juice. That one was really, really good. But you're not going there for the pineapple juice. So we wouldn't really recommend it. But maybe it's just because we ruined it ourselves with the spicy sauce and by letting it cool down. So don't order this for takeaway.
Good morning, we are driving to our breakfast spot. And the sun is actually shining for the first time. So we were really excited. But I did put on my joggers. I actually do have Air Max because I wanted to try it first. But I did bring my joggers. But maybe it will be a really nice day. Because from 5 o'clock this afternoon, there won't be any clouds anymore. Because we were not really lucky with the weather here in LA. Every day was really cloudy. Or we've been here for 2 days. But the weather's been really cloudy. And it was really, really cold yesterday. Yesterday I actually switched from my joggers to like a t-shirt and shorts, and then the whole day I was cold and like it was really, really cold and windy. So now I decided to put on my sweats again, but now the sun is actually shining, so I'm really hoping it will be warm today. The sun is warm, so I hope it will be out the whole day. But we are now driving to our breakfast spot. Oh, and we didn't bring any like clean longer clothes or long pants, so we had to wear the joggers from the airplane. So it's kind of gross, but we didn't really have a choice. But now we're driving to our breakfast spot and we are going to get like it's this place and they are on Melrose Avenue and they are known for their French toast, and it's this French toast with berries, and it looks really, really good. So we're going to take that, and then we'll just check the menu and we'll find something else. But I'm really excited because this is the first time we are actually going out for breakfast. We just finished our breakfast and this was my favorite food up till now. I give it a 10 out of 10. The only thing I didn't like was the matcha latte as my drink. An iced matcha latte with oat milk. I didn't like it. I think I just don't like matchas, because I had it once before at Starbucks. And I didn't know if it was just the one from Starbucks that I didn't like, but I just didn't like it. So that was the only thing. But like the toast was really, really good, and also the egg sandwich, really, really good. So, and it was also really, like you said, like the place we sat outside, and it looked really cute, and we sat outside and it looked also really cute. So yeah, I recommend. Service was also really good. We were at the one at Melrose Avenue. I think they have like 5 locations in LA. And you pay at the, like you order at the, you have to order yourself. And then you go to your table and they bring it to your. So we already gave the tip. But then when we got our food, we actually got free water with mint and lemon, which was really good. And we also got free orange juice with ginger shots, which were also really good. So the service was also really good. Now we are going to Santa Monica and Venice Beach. We are going to park our car and then get a bike, so we can bike all over, like alongside the beach. And then we actually wanted to get a donut, but we are really, really full from this, so probably won't get a donut. And after that, if we have time, we are going shopping. And then tonight we are going to eat at the Cheesecake Factory, which I'm really excited for. And then at night, because the sun will be out from 5, and there won't be any clouds, so we really want to get the sunset and go to Rodeo Drive and Beverly Hills and stuff. So that's kind of the planning for today. But now we're going to Santa Monica, so the Santa Monica Pier. We are now actually waiting for an Uber, because we tried to book the like the bikes or maybe a step or something, but you need a US phone number, so we couldn't do it. And we actually can do it with the Uber step, but they are not here at the Santa Monica Pier, so we are just getting an Uber back to our car, because it's a 15-minute walk and our legs are already sore, because we actually wanted to take the bike like to the Santa Monica Pier and then back to our car. But we couldn't take the bike, and then we thought maybe we could just get an Uber step on our way back. But they are not here, so we're just taking an Uber. It's only $9, so. And then we are actually going to the Grove, which is a shopping mall here in LA. It's a really big one and it looks really nice. So I'm really excited to go. They have a lot of nice shops like Sephora, Aritzia, Brandy Melville. I'm not sure. I made a list where I want to go. Victoria's Secret. Oh, and they have Skims in Nordstrom, so I really want to go to Nordstrom. But I'll show you.
Hello.
Hi.
Heart starts beating out my chest. Breath strains in and out. fought this feeling long enough. Can't escape you now. Just a word, just a glimpse. I'm a soul in eclipse, overtaking. My defense is for you, the altar call for my saving.
I didn't buy anything at the shops, and we have a bit of a change of plans because we actually wanted to go to the Cheesecake Factory, but it's still kind of cold, so I don't really want to go into my joggers into the Cheesecake Factory because it's kind of more fancy, or it's not really fancy, but yeah, it is. This is a restaurant, so we decided to change our dinner from tomorrow, switch it with this night's dinner. So we are going to Panda Express, and then for dessert we are going to Krispy Kreme. Those two are both my favorites, so I'm really excited. I always get the orange chicken and the broccoli beef and then the noodles, and Krispy Kreme are the best donuts, but I'll show you everything. That was really, really good again. Now off to Krispy Kreme.
Can we get four glazed donuts?
Four glazed?
Yes.
Can
you get
for you?
No, thank you.
Okay.
Yes.
We got a free donut. Ik denk dat deze al heel duur is of zo. Eentje heeft een donutje gehad. Yeah. Okay, we just ordered the donuts and we got the free donut. This location was really, really expensive. Last year we also went, but we went in Florida. And they were way cheaper. And when we checked the site, they are only $1 a piece. And these ones were $2.40. So it was $10 for 4 donuts, because we got one each, and then for tomorrow we also have one each, because tomorrow we are going to Sequoia National Park and we wanted one for on the road. And I also got dit is echt leuk, hè, voor onze koffietje. And I also got the tumbler to drink iced coffee at home, because we always use one from Starbucks, and now we also have one from Krispy Kreme. I maybe also want one from Dunkin' Donuts, but I'm not sure if they have one, like a clear one. And this one, and the tumbler was $11, so the total was $21. Oh, and I forgot to say, we always take the glazed donuts, just the basic ones. They also have a lot of flavors, but we have never taken those. We really like the original ones. We just ate the free one and it was kind of different than we were used to. Because the free one, it was kind of like oily and not as crispy. We just got out of the Target and we just did a little quick grocery shop. We first got Prime, because every store we check if they have Prime, because we really want to get all of the flavors. So now we managed to get the other one. Then we got breakfast for tomorrow. First we got bagels. Then we got on top of the bagels some turkey cheese. Then just a big bottle of water. And a lot of small bottles. Thank you. morning, guys. We are leaving LA, so we are just checking out. Or not really checking out. It's an Airbnb. We can just leave. But before we leave LA and I close off this vlog, I really want to let you know what we thought about this Airbnb for anybody who's interested. The location was why we booked this. And also, like, the price combination. And like the location, it's in the middle of Beverly Hills. It's a really good location. Like the Airbnb itself, it's a little bit, it's not the cleanest. Like there's hairs and dust and I don't know, it's not the cleanest. Also we didn't have warm water in the shower. And we did tell them and they said they could send someone over, but we didn't really wanna like go through all that because we're on holiday. So we just sorry, I'm out of breath, but so we just took cold showers. So I haven't washed my hair because like washing my hair with cold water, that's like another level. So that were like the two cons of this place. But otherwise, like location and price wise like it's still really expensive. LA is really expensive, but we really wanted a good location. And you still have to drive everywhere, but because we are in the middle of Beverly Hills, like we had to drive a little bit less. So yeah, that's our Airbnb. We are now leaving to Fresno. We are going to Sequoia and then sleeping in Fresno. And then tomorrow we are going to Yosemite. Those will be the next vlogs. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this vlog. And I hope to see you next time. Bye bye.